I think it's true for all of us, but working on this film was a life-changing experience.
I thought I came across as somewhat of an idiot. You know, well-intentioned, God knows, but a little bit of an idiot.
I was 19 years old, and I picked up a magazine, and there was a little classified ad in the back of the magazine, which read, "We are looking for a gay male to work on a film about gay lifestyles. No experience necessary, just insane dedication and a cooperative spirit."
Peter had a passion about his own life and about gay people. There were no images of gay people. And I remember him saying he was going to make this film no matter what.
It was the scariest thing. It was like very scary. It was like someone, if you're at a swimming pool and someone said, "Jump off the high board."
And here were a small group of us that had been gathered on the stage, and the light was shown on us and said, "Now you speak."
My dad calls and he says, "Cindy, I understand you've been in a movie." And I thought, oh boy.
I had only been out a few years, and I was kind of naive about the whole thing, honestly. And my picture was in the Sunday New York Times, and somebody sent a picture to the mayor and said, "Did you know you have a lesbian vet in town? I think you ought to run her out of town."
Peter told me, and Vito told me, I couldn't dare. They said, we've got too many dykes in the woods. We need to get some business types in here. But my motivation originally was just to kind of push the peanut along and do what I could for the cause.
Peter turned over the power of the director to the Mariposa Film Group, to all of us. We all participated equally in the shaping of the film. I don't think that we ever really saw ourselves as filmmakers and the other people were subjects. We didn't ever feel separate from who we were talking with.
Most of us aren't from here originally, and we came out here for a reason, and there was a certain culture going on out here that wasn't going on anywhere else in the country. Communal culture.
I mean, the other thing is that we had a lot of fun. We were also, each of us, in our own way, continuing to come out. So the process was so...
self-exploratory.
It was self-exploratory, it was affirmative, it was...
A fun time.
It was incredible.
How many people?
I'm sure at least 100. Like, I know I had at least 25.
Day after day after day.
Peter really guided us through those shoots. He was there at all of them. He did the lighting. I mean, he really... And then he's kind of just sat back and...
What the...
I'm living out a dream that I and many others of us had, because every morning I go into this small town and I do yoga, and then I talk with Republicans and Mormons and Baptists, and we disagree, but we love each other.
We got 9 grandkids.
9 grandchildren.
And 2 great-grandchildren.
2 great-grandchildren. And they just turned out great. They really did.
No
shame.
You.
Oh, thanks. Did I grow up already? I wasn't supposed to.
I know.
Mm.